and this here may be tough to you. Snack cake to me, yeah, more hosts.
All hosts.
This been overdue forever. Asked me when it was dropping, said never.
Never.
Should've made you cut the feather, but I designed it Freemason Margiela.
What's goody, Shell? Trying here the most woke, no joking. I'm back at it again with a brand new video, and I'm gonna keep it up, Bo Bray Biscuit. This is a really big game for the Panthers. And honestly, we all saw what happened Monday night. Now, if you missed that game and you didn't see what happened Monday night, you missed what I might call actually a massacre. Now, I think we've all seen some form of violence before in our life, be it in a movie, be it in the news. You know, we see a lot of different things, you know, maybe even in your daily life, you've seen some form of violence, even like emotional violence. But what happened Monday night between the Redskins and the Saints was honestly worse than any other form of violence that I've ever witnessed in my life. But before I get into all that, and before I get into the preview in the game between the Panthers and the Redskins, I do want to give a quick shout out to my man, Pat Coltrane, man. That man has some really good content with the live streams, and he's always on, always grinding, man. So check him out, and honestly, check out anyone else who's doing Panthers content around YouTube or wherever else it is. Some of us may have different opinions on different things, but we're all just one fam, you know what I'm saying? So definitely check them out and let them know I said, what's up with you, baby Bubba? Anyway, y'all, this game between the Saints and the Redskins was so ridiculous. I have to talk about this game before I talk about the Panthers game because it honestly blew my mind. Honestly, I have no other words. I have no idea what happened. Honestly, the whole first half was just disgusting. I didn't see a single drive, a single play that I liked out of the Redskins. The Redskins looked so tough in two of their first three games that I thought, you know, maybe they would have a shot, a chance at making this game even look semi-competitive. But honestly, there was not a single moment in this game where I thought to myself, you know, the Redskins are playing solid NFL football right now. Because there was no point during this game where I saw a single NFL player wearing red. Maybe they treated that game like Kobe's last game where literally no one played defense on him. The man put up, what, like 53 shots and what he had, like 64 points at the end of it. They were just all in awe and in shock of Drew Brees. This man had 3 touchdown passes and only 3 incompletions all game. What was it, 26 for 29 and 320-something? This man played out of his mind. And it looked like the Redskins were off their game all game. Now, just think about this. I was talking to some guys during the game, and we all agreed that after that record-setting pass that ended up being a touchdown for Drew Brees, what followed was probably the most disrespectful and honestly, maybe even the most fight-worthy thing I've ever seen in an NFL game in my entire, I don't know how long I've been watching the NFL, years, a decade, more than a decade, honestly. Just imagine you're on the sideline, not the good sideline, the other sideline, when that pass goes up. The man's wide open, it's like a 50-yard touchdown, and you have to go out to your sideline, you're thinking to yourself, okay, we'll get him back on this next drive, we still have over 2 minutes left in this half, we can score or do something. But then you see the whole team come out to rush Drew Brees, congratulating him, he gets the ball back. You see the referees hand this man a certificate in the middle of the field. You think to yourself, okay, well, we'll have maybe 30 more seconds, maybe a minute more of this, and then we can, you know, get on the field with a kickoff. We'll return the ball. We can have a drive and get it going, right? Nope. This man has his family out there. He's talking to his kids. He said, boys, you can do anything in life as long as you work for it. The Redskins players looking across the field like, I don't know, Dad. I don't think we can do this. I don't believe in myself. And Drew's like, yeah, that's why I'm about to lose by 30, boy. And I don't know what happened. It blew my mind. They did literally everything but bring out cake for the whole team to slice and to sit down at tables with fold-out chairs like, hey, we're going to eat this till we get a flag or something. Give us an excessive celebration. Give us a delay of game. What it's going to be? Because we chilling out here. And I thought for half a second that I saw Lil Wayne actually say, you know what? I'm going to start my halftime show right now. It was like, what, 2:48, 2:30 left in the half. I think I saw Lil Wayne say, am I on now, coach? Do I just go ahead and get this started right here? I really thought that the Redskins were going to all pull a Vontae Davis and quit at half. No lie. I thought they were all going to quit the game at halftime and say, look, coach, I'm retired for the night. You better find some practice players. You better find them replacements of somebody. Hey, call them up from the stands. I don't know what to do. And they really honestly should have just called random fans down from the stands to play because their big name players didn't do a thing. I think AP, Adrian Peterson, that's his real name now. He's not AP anymore. His name is Adrian Peterson. He had 4 carries for 6 yards. Jordan Reed, easily probably their best receiver. Maybe Jameson Crowder, I don't know, but I think it's Jordan Reed, honestly. He had 1 catch all game. Are you serious? Jordan Reed had 1 catch for 21 yards and then left. I didn't see a single player on the Redskins show up in a big moment. It's like they really just gave up. And it's kind of strange because the Redskins have played really well against competitive teams so far. They did lose to the Colts, but they did stop that man Aaron Rodgers and the Packers a couple weeks back. So I was thinking, you know, maybe the Redskins are actually competitive. But honestly, it's looking like it's shaping up to be another year for the Redskins to be one of the better mediocre teams in the league. Another one of those 9-7 or 7-9 kind of seasons for them, which is pretty much par for the course for any NFC East team. And this is where I get into it for the Panthers game. Right now, honestly, their run game is looking really shot. I'm not sure who their running back is. Sometimes it's Adrian Peterson, but he really kind of vultures those goal line attempts. Some, I don't really see him getting a lot of chunk yardage or a lot of explosive plays too much. Chris Thompson, is he nice? He had 8 carries for 17 yards. I don't know if it's him. There's no real set, like, actual great receiver on their team. Now, like I said, Jordan Reed is basically a really, really good receiver, but I don't really see him being consistently on and being that guy. Alex Smith, as their quarterback, he puts up numbers. I will not deny that. But honestly, was he better than Kirk Cousins? He's 4 years older and they paid him about the same. I don't know what the front office of the Redskins is doing. But when it comes to the Panthers, we stopped the run. Or we used to, and we need to get back to doing that. I think with us having Thomas Davis Sr. back in the lineup, and I did a video on him. You can see it above my head. Click that little eye icon on the video. You can find that. But Thomas Davis Sr. coming back in this week is a really bad sign for the Redskins because we'll have a much better core for stopping that run this week, and our pass rush is going to be a lot stronger, and the defense as a whole is going to be a much more cohesive group. I think Eric Reed getting the swing of things, having another week under his belt to be, you know, more NFL ready. Cam Newton getting back in this thing. I think we have to get back to being committed to the run. Christian McCaffrey has to find and establish he can be an inside runner in these games more consistently. But I will say we do need to integrate CJ Anderson a little bit more in the run. I would say 70-30. Not exactly a split back situation, but a little bit more CJ Anderson. Not just like 2 or 3 carries. I mean, why else did we bring him onto the team if he's only going to get like 3 carries per game? That's not the real focus here. The Redskins have a really good run-stopping defense. I will deny that. The Redskins will do really well against the run. But honestly, if we can establish our passing game. A lot of you guys had a lot of things to say about Ian Thomas. I think only one of those interceptions was his problem. I think on the second interception, he was sitting down in the zone like a veteran kind of receiver would do. He sat down between where the linebacker was and where the corner playing the sideline was. And he was in the perfect position, but Cam felt pressure off the left side and threw a pass off target. I think Ian Thomas was just sitting exactly where he should have been. He just was the target of a pass that was thrown too far to the left. I do not believe that second interception was on him. I think Cam just threw it off kilter. Well, my point is, we have our weapons back in the receiving core. We have 7 guys. I think 7 guys who can catch the ball and can do a lot of different things for us. I'm also including Christian McCaffrey in there. But we need to see more of Darius Wright. We need to see more of DJ Moore. This man does not go down on the first hit. I think he's only had 1 catch so far this whole season where he's gone down at the initial hit. I think he's number 1 for receivers in yards after contact. This man, DJ Moore, is strong, like James Winston used to say. But I mean, we need to see more out of him. Curtis Samuel. Like I said, Torrey Smith, need to see more out of him. We need to see these guys flourish. I think we have 5 receivers who are all averaging over 13 yards per catch. Now, 2 of those guys only have 2 receptions, and 1 of those guys is Greg Olsen, so it doesn't really count. But the other guy with only 2 receptions is Curtis Samuel, and his 2 catches were for 25 and 12. So I think we have a really strong core of guys who can catch after the run. And I think Bill Voth just tweeted, just today I think, a next-gen stat that shows that Cam hasn't completed a single pass for over 20 yards, which means that for our guys getting these long receptions, they're all getting yards after the catch and even yards after contact. So even though we don't really throw the ball too deep too often, I think we have 10 or less attempts of 20 yards or more, our guys are still getting chunk yardage on those short plays. And I think that's what's really going to be the big thing for us. These short passes, these intermediate passes, and establishing the run and being committed to the run. Even when it shows it's not really working too much, if you're going to be a running team, you have to run the ball. Some of my biggest questions for this game is, how is Alex Smith going to play? Will the Redskins' run game step up? Will our run defense step up? Will Eric Reed have a much bigger impact in this game than he did before? I mean, Mike Adams did all the work. They were throwing straight at Mike Adams. I think that we didn't really see too many looks at Eric Reed's side, but he wasn't a snap count, so he didn't really play too much. Will our run defense step up? Can we establish a pass rush? We have good run defense, and we have a decent pass rush for the first half of the game, but it's like our guys get gassed, and we just get torched second half. We should really not be getting gassed in the second half with the elite players we have in our front seven. So I need to see us, at the point of attack, have a lot more impact in the long run for the game. And that includes, you know, a little bit more exotic, maybe blitzes, maybe some different looks on defense to keep the offense confused. And on the offensive side of the ball, we have to keep letting North Turner do what North Turner does. Now, I will say, I think he did try to get a little bit too cute in his play calling later on in the game, but I do respect him and his aggressiveness and his ability and his willingness to do things out of the norm. So honestly, keep doing what you're doing. I cannot fault you in a win. I know the old saying, don't accept anything in a win that you wouldn't in a loss. But Norv, I gotta believe in you. This is the most exciting and the most dynamic our offense has looked in a while now. And am I gonna sit here and criticize you after only 4 games, 3 wins? I think I'm gonna ride the train a little bit longer, man. I got a couple more stops to go before I reach my destination. And I think that with the NFC looking a lot weaker than what was predicted, I think there's only 4 teams in the NFC with winning records. It's us, the Saints, the Bears, and is it the Packers? No, it's not the Packers. It's the Rams. We could be in a really good position to clinch maybe even kind of early. So we have to keep our foot on the pedal here, beat the Redskins. This is going to be a closer game. This will not be the blowout that it was for the Redskins Monday. This will be a much closer game. I'm thinking it's probably going to be something like maybe 17-21. Kind of a low-scoring affair. Very defensive, but some chunk plays here and there from both teams. I think we win this game kind of early in the fourth quarter, and both teams trade punts and good defensive stands later on in the game. But let me know what you guys think. What are your predictions for the game? Score predictions? Stat predictions? What will we see out of both teams? Let me know in the comments below. And you already know to do that like button.
Cheers to you, appreciate the chance. Being told y'all I've been the man. Being told y'all I had the gift. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Real ones gonna recommend. Count this as another win.